Power of Your Spirit, A Guide to Joyful Living, read by me, Sonia Choquette. Introduction. Several months ago, I found myself in a hotel room in San Diego after presenting an all-day workshop to several hundred people. Tired and ready to relax, I decided to order room service and rent a movie. After skimming through the selections for something light and funny, I finally settled on a romantic comedy called My Life in Ruins. The movie itself was cute enough, but the main character's struggle actually made a big impression on me. Georgia, a young Greek-American tour guide living in Greece, is unhappy and frustrated with life. Her friends tell her it's because she has lost her kephi, a Greek word for spirit. To them, this was the obvious reason for her misery and why nothing in her life seemed to work out. To make matters worse, no person or event could change her situation. It was up to Georgia to rediscover her magic power, her kephi. Otherwise, her world would remain colorless, uninspiring, and most likely, loveless. Only she could uncover her inner spark and get back into the flow of life. Like most Hollywood stories, this one has a happy ending. Georgia reconnects with her spirit, and she finds that her life once again has profound meaning, laughter, and love. That night, I went to sleep feeling happy and relieved. One more person who found her spirit, even if only in the movies, meant one less miserable person in the world. Hooray! The film reminded me that the idea of losing your connection to spirit isn't that unusual. In fact, it might be the most common problem from which people suffer today. In my 35 years of experience as a professional intuitive counselor and teacher, I've come across this quite often. Through my one-on-one intuitive sessions and the classes I teach, I work intimately with thousands of men and women all over the world. I continually encounter incredibly lovely, generous, and caring individuals who feel lost, disillusioned, and powerless. Yet, most of them also know in their hearts that there must be another way to live. Reconnecting with your divine self. We all want to successfully deal with challenges, face disappointment with grace, tap into our inner power and creative expression, feel excited by a purpose, and live by an intuitive guiding wisdom. We want to be more spontaneous and carefree, laughing or singing out loud, and dancing with abandon. We want to open our hearts, leave our fears behind, and find genuine peace, no matter what is happening around us. To put it simply, like Georgia, we want to reclaim our kephi and get our spirit back. But as much as we wish for a significant spiritual breakthrough, as much as we long to know our divine self and uncover our intuitive genius, we're still not making the commitment that will ensure our success. We want the gifts, but we aren't engaging in the practical work necessary to obtain them. So we remain stuck and more discouraged than ever. When it comes to being empowered, we're like window shoppers on Madison Avenue, gazing longingly at the incredible possibilities dangling before our eyes, yet not claiming them as our own. I believe the reason for this frustration and spiritual impasse is that way too many of us are trying to make a transformational, energetic shift through intellectual means alone. We make the mistake of thinking that knowing something is the equivalent of integrating and embodying this wisdom into our being. In other words, we know a lot about the power of spirit, but we aren't actually experiencing it. And we can't do so through intellectual pursuits alone. In fact, we cannot experience the power of spirit through the intellect or ego at all. It is only achievable through a deep, intentional, daily practice of connecting with spirit. This is the most authentic, lasting power we have in our lives. We can't control the outside world, but with the power of spirit, we can create a sense of purpose within that brings about deep satisfaction and personal peace, regardless of what is going on around us. We can't be truly happy without making this connection and surrendering to our spirit. Otherwise, it's like being lost in the jungle with no clear path, no orientation, no clue as to how to find our way home. This state of mind is quite similar to the stress, fear, and exhaustion so many of us feel on a daily basis. We have become submissive, duality-based, ego-identified victims. We've been conditioned to, and even forced into, handing our power over to others, only for it to be used against us. We've been misguided or misdirected in almost every imaginable way. And we've accepted and woven this belief system into our cellular bodies and even our DNA. We've been trained to think that we are something other than what we really are. And instead of using our divinely appointed creative spiritual powers, we believe what we have been told, that we are unlovable, unworthy, and even at times, unwanted. We've convinced ourselves that we're tainted, broken beings who must submit to others in order to feel love or achieve success. The perpetual stress and internal chaos of a life without the power of spirit causes innumerable physical and psychological breakdowns and even accidents. The more I think about it, the more I am convinced that the loss of spirit is the root cause for most depression, addiction, disease, and discontent. But the worst consequence of a life disconnected from spirit is that we lose touch with our deepest sense of personal creativity, which is the spark of spirit in action. A life without genuine creative expression lacks meaning and purpose. People in this state tend to find negative ways to distract themselves and deaden the emptiness they feel. Whether this leads to destructive behaviors or emotions, frequent accidents or illnesses, career stalls or chronic unemployment, or outbursts of rage or social withdrawal, soon the problem becomes others' problems as well. All paths are interwoven. We are connected to one another. And one person's misery eventually affects everyone else. Therefore, not only is our connection to spirit an essential personal need, it's also a profoundly important familial and social need. Pursuing your spirit over ego provides a deep-seated, unwavering sense of protection and safety. It relaxes your mind, puts your body at ease, and opens your heart. A connection to spirit restores your confidence, relieves your anxiety, and frees you from the desire to control everything in your life. With such a big load off your shoulders, you can actually begin to sense your intuition, the voice of your spirit, which is extremely subtle at first. And when you're under a lot of stress, it's easily missed. With intuition firmly at the helm of your life, you reconnect with the deepest, most authentic truth of your being and remember who you are as God designed and created you to be. Perfect, beautiful, and whole. With spirit as your guide, you don't have to base your identity or self-worth on how people view you. Because you know who you are, you're free to be yourself and can experience others as they are as well. You no longer need to get anyone else's approval. Such authentic self-awareness encourages the same transformation in others when they're in your presence. Everyone you interact with energetically senses your genuineness. So the typical manipulations people engage in to feel safe and win approval cease, and more heart-to-heart connections take their place. You no longer feel the need to struggle with others for power because your power arises from within. So bit by bit.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.